Time to start the rebellion in Attack on Titan Season 3. So what's up guys, Foxen here. Oh right, I meant the uprising. Anyway, we have a very juicy episode this week. First off, let me talk about the media censorship. In that one specific reporter scene, it almost makes you want to throw up at how freaking corrupt these guys are, not even being that secretive about it. Oh yeah, by the way, don't mention anything about Kenny's squad. Not unless you want to get a personal one-on-one interview. I guess Sanis and his crew isn't enough. You gotta make the press bend over backwards for the king too. Talk about that propo. At least Neo isn't completely brainwashed by them. He's fully aware that Kenny's squad could one day be unleashed on his ass. Best be careful. As for Hitch and Marlo, Annie's best buddies are back this episode. I gotta love the shot of Armin becoming that gun collector. Armin already got a taste, and I'm sure he wants some more. By the way, I do love this shot of Quinny with that hat. Just looks kind of funny. But back to Hitch and Mr. Friendzoned. Really nice to see Hitch back. She did have a recent cameo in Annie's Lost Girl Story OVA. I think that special helped to highlight that she was actually Annie's friend and cared about her. You do see more of this in this episode. Hitch is super pissed off that Annie got killed by the female Titan in that attack. This really goes to show how much information is kept tight. These guys are in the military police, but still, only as super low-ranking officers. When you find out that your roommate was the female Titan so suddenly, no surprise that she was totally in shock. Sorry, Hitch. As for Marlo right here, this guy reminds me a bit of Ida from My Hero Academia. Just being this person with a super high sense of justice and always wanting to follow the rules, even if at times it's to a very stupid extent. Now for Horse Boy. After almost getting himself killed, he's now stepping up to the plate and testing these military police newbies. But holy crap, Horseface just got Negan by Hitch. Ouch. I'm not sure why I would risk myself getting freaking shanked just to see if these fellows were trustworthy. But hey, it paid off. Jean, you did good today. You're on your way to becoming that stallion. Next up, the Reeve son. You got Hanji Spider-Manning his ass out of there. So Hanji kind of forced him into joining them in her own way. Oh, and the best line here from the manga has to be Hanji mentioning how failure or loss is what the Survey Corps has always known. The unfortunate sad truth. All of them are highly experienced losers. Reeves, you're now part of them. As for Hanji's little plan involving him, glad the Reeves bonds finally grew a pair. I do like that you can still hear the hesitation in his voice and words. By the way, about this military police officer, way to overreact with that crying act. To be fair, I guess anyone would if Kenny was potentially after your ass. Anyway, Hanji really got more time to shine this episode. More Spider-Manning in with Hanji's super kick, then one punching that a-hole in the freaking face. I know it hurt, but that was totally worth it. And then you got the Reeves on going in for that ass head crusher. Military police, you got KO'd. Because really, these guys got totally played, revealing the whole truth to a town of people, and even the press that actually cares. So about that revolution, time for the rebellion to actually begin. As for Levi's attack on that military police headquarter compound, I totally saw this being changed for the anime. At this point, it was fun to see the Survey Corps' wild attack on their campsite instead. Really love seeing Levi dragging this piece of crap over to the other guys. And on top of this, I'm really glad that they kept some of Savage Levi in the anime. A lot of people would pay a good chunk of cash for that privilege. Although better to leave some teeth in so this guy could actually spill the juicy info. Unfortunately, this guy didn't know crap though. The only useful information from this guy was that Ackerman name drop for Kenny. So that's right, Kenny Ackerman, finally revealed in the anime. I wonder how Levi feels about Uncle Kenny and him having a connection to Mikasa. And then last up, Erwin. Poor guy. He's gone from Survey Corps Commander to Titan Chutoi. And now he's sitting in Mr. Gray's awful dungeon. Erwin's taken so much crap in this cruel world. At the end there, he finally got the shot from one of the visuals. Erwin in front of that king. Dun dun dun. Anyway, let me hear your thoughts on this episode. How do you feel about Erwin being abused? Did anyone love Horseboy's big moment here? And are you glad to see Savage Levi coming out to play? Anyway, definitely give this a colossal thumbs up and subscribe. If you're new to the channel, I put out 5 plus anime videos here every week. Check out my breakdown video for the previous episode going over all the changes, cuts, and censors seen in Historia's episode. There's gonna be one for this episode too in a few days. Definitely subscribe so you don't miss out, and I'll see you guys later.